directly ask. I give a question. Sine C 3 omega by 7. What is the first zero crossing of this sine C 3 omega by 7? And what is the peak value of this sinc function is? First I draw. For first zero crossing, whatever the value is given to us is known as sin c x. X should be n pi plus minus. For first zero crossing, n should be 1. 3 omega upon 7 equals to pi plus pi. Omega equals to 3 pi by 7 pi by 3. 7 pi by 3 and so on. 14 pi by 3 as in negative also same. Negative also. Peak value of this sinc function is by putting this term x equals to 0, we got 1. Peak value of this sinc function is 1. 1 here. We can calculate sinc function directly from here. This first zero crossing define bandwidth of the signal. Rectangular pulse bandwidth t by 2 minus t by 2 rect a rect sinc function is at sine c omega t by 2. Sinc function is drawn as peak value is at, first zero crossing is pi, omega equals to 2 pi upon t, first zero crossing is 2 pi upon t, which is bandwidth of the rectangular pulse, because it is just frequency domain conversion of rectangular pulse. It directly gives the bandwidth to rectangular pulse. It is very useful in digital communication. We directly use in digital communication. By this rectangular pulse, we have one more conclusion. If signal is time bounded in time, then it can't be bounded in frequency, because rectangular pulse is bounded in time, bounded within time t. So Fourier transform of rectangular pulse is sinc function which is not bounded in omega frequency domain, which is spread up to minus infinite to infinite. So signal can't be time limited and band limited simultaneously. A signal can't be time limited and band limited simultaneously. Can't be band limited and time limited simultaneously. One more rectangular pulse took as an example, xt equals to a rect t upon 2t. What is the Fourier transform of this rectangular pulse is? Let us see. First we draw width of this rectangular pulse is 2t. Magnitude is A. We want to calculate the Fourier transform. By putting into the formula e power j omega t dt. By solving this, we got A e power j omega t minus j omega t upon plus j omega, bracket close, 2a upon omega sine omega t. We can convert into sinc function. 2at sine omega t upon omega t. 2at sine sinc omega t. With the expansion in time domain, frequency domain should be compression. How it is possible? We will check from sinc function. 2at sine c omega t. We will draw this in frequency domain. Peak of this sinc function is 2at. First zero crossing, omega t equals to n pi plus minus. For first zero crossing, n equals to 1. So value of omega is pi by t. Previously it is 2 pi by t. Now it is pi by t. Bandwidth is reduced by, it is known as first zero crossing is known as bandwidth of the signal. Bandwidth is reduced by half by scaling. By expanding the time domain signal, bandwidth is reduced by half. It is direct relation between time domain signal and frequency domain signal. Now we start with Fourier transform. Fourier transform of some specific signal. Question 1. If xt is, here Fourier transform is x omega, then calculate the following Fourier transform. X of 3t plus 7 b x of 3t minus 7 c x of minus 3t minus 7 d x of minus 3t plus 7. We want to perform Fourier transform for scaled and shifted signal directly by using formula and change of variable. Just from formula we have xt e power j omega t minus dt. Xt is, now revise. To revise xt is placed instead of using xt. By putting new xt, we get new Fourier transform of the signal. We using at this time idea of change of variable only. For change of variable, 3t plus 7 mark p. Solve for t. p minus 7 divided by 3. Newly modified Fourier transform is, by putting lower limit, limit is minus infinite. I put minus infinite here, we get p equals to minus infinite, because larger limit, same, no effect on limit. Ocean, no effect on limit. Infinite, again ocean, no effect on limit. X of p e power minus j omega p minus 7 divided by 3 for dt dp by 3. In this expression, constant should be come out of integration. Remaining terms are plus j omega 7 by 3 integration minus infinite infinite xp e power minus j omega p divided by 3 dp 1 by 3. This term is synonym to xt. This term synonym to e minus is also similar, j same similar, omega similar, t similar with p, dp divided by 3 is extra term, so we have to use here x omega by 3 and remaining terms as it is, divide by 3 e power j omega 7 by 3. Now modified Fourier transform is have some phase shift with some magnitude reduction divided by 3. This amount of modification in Fourier transform of previous case, some scaling is done and some phase shift. Same way, in same pattern, we can apply to question number 2, question number 3 and question number 4. We got different type of result. I applied directly to question number 2nd. Now apply this shifting idea, change of variable idea to question number 2. X 3t minus 7. What is the value of Fourier transform of this is? Directly put into the formula. X 3t minus 7 e power j omega t dt. 3t minus 7 equals to p. Solve for t. P plus 7 divided by 3. Limit has no effect. So, directly solve in this way. P plus 7 divided by 3 dp by 3. Dt equals to dp by 3. E power minus j omega 7 by 3. XP e power j omega 7 by 3 dp divided by 3. Now conclusion is, all term are similar to previous case, but difference is x omega by 3 e power j omega 7 by 3 upon 3. In same pattern, we can solve question C. Answer will be, answer will be calculate directly, but there is some difference. So I solve question number C. Minus 3t minus 7 e power dt. Minus 3t minus 7 equals to p. Minus d 3 dt equals to dp. 3. By putting limit into this xp e power minus j omega, value of t is p plus 7 divided by 3 with minus sign. Divide by 3 dp divide by 3. Infinite for lower limit converted into higher limit and higher limit converted into lower limit. So we have to reverse that. With minus is consumed for reversing the limit. Now x of p e power minus j omega p divided by 3 with minus sign dp e power plus j 7 omega by 3 divided by 3. This term is similar with x of minus omega by 3. An additional term available to us is 7 omega by 3 complete divided by 3. This is the actually modification in Fourier transform of previous case. Minus 7. For question number D, now we can write directly answer to the question. Directly Fourier transform to the question, because we solve all three pattern. Now last one is solve independently. I directly write the answer. Minus j 7 omega by 3. Answer for last one. Same practice for inverse also. Change of variable also applicable in inverse case. If we have x 4 omega plus 3, if we xt is x omega, we want to calculate x dash t, inverse of this. With the help of inverse formula, we can calculate x omega e power j omega dt. X dash t equals to 1 upon 2 pi minus infinite to infinite x 4 omega plus 3 e power j omega t dt. 4 omega plus 3 equals to p. 4 d omega equals to dp. Omega equals to dp by 4. By putting all the values, due to higher values, no effect on the limit. Limit is unchanged. Xp e power plus j, value of omega is p minus 3 divided by 4. P minus 3 divided by 4 dp upon 4. 1 by 4 1 upon 2 pi e power j p j 3 t by 4 integration minus infinite to infinite x of p e power minus plus j p t upon 4 dp. This term is synonym with this term. X of p e j j omega p dp d omega here dp d omega and t means this term now represented as one by four e power plus 3 t by 4 x of t by 4, not plus here, it is minus here from previous expression, it is minus. We can apply change of variable in inverse case also and forward case also. In both cases we can apply change of variable. Now we discuss the properties of Fourier transform, different properties, and which is helpful to us. If change of variable we are applying change of variable, no property to be learned. If we learn the property, then it is good. If we are using change of variable, it is also good, because we are not depend on particular formulas on properties. We are depend on change of variable method.